The Situation Room with Wolf Blitzer, weekday afternoons at 5 Eastern on CNN.
It looks like phase two of this military operation against Gaddafi has started.
Well, it certainly does, and it certainly looks like it's much more than just a simple no-fly operation. It is clear that the objectives are well beyond simply trying to ensure that the aircraft of the Libyan Air Force don't fly. It looks like the objectives and the end state that the militaries are seeking is far more profound than simply keeping airplanes out of the air.
Well, what does that mean? To destroy the Libyan military? Is that what you're saying?
Well, look, I mean, if we are going after the command nodes, if we are going after the missile nodes, if we're going after tanks on the ground, it is clear that our objectives are more than just simply trying to keep aircraft out of the air. It looks like this is part of a larger air campaign, not dissimilar to what we saw in 99 in Kosovo, where the objectives are well beyond just keeping aircraft out of the air.
It's what I've been told by top U.S. officials, civilian as well as military, is the real goal is to develop a wedge between Gaddafi and his own military to convince his military leaders, the generals, the colonels, the others, it's over, and save yourselves and break away from Gaddafi. Is that what you're hearing as well?
Well, I think let's look at what's really going on here. Yes, in fact, we're trying to separate the warring factions, the rebels on one side and the Libyan military on the other side. But that is to stop the humanitarian situation on the ground. But it's clear that we want to see Gaddafi gone. We want to see not only the military separate, but we also want to see Gaddafi evicted. Whether that's done by us or whether that's done by his own people, the president has been very clear. President Gaddafi, Colonel Gaddafi, has lost the legitimacy of his people, and he's looking at very many different options for making sure that Gaddafi does not stay in power. Whether that's
Let me ask you a blunt question on that specific point. We know that the U.S., the British, the French troops, they're going after what they call command and control headquarters for the Libyan military. The commander of the Libyan military is Gaddafi. Are they trying, in effect, to kill him?
Well, I think first what they're trying to do is isolate Gaddafi from his forces electronically or through kinetic means so he is unable to command his forces. But there's a second message, and every one of those colonels and generals sitting in those command centers need to know that they're targets too. So they have a very simple equation that they've got to deal with. Do I want to stick with Gaddafi, or do I want to be on the right side of history and perhaps assist the transition within Libya and make it a little more rapid than might otherwise come about through a simple air campaign?
General Kimmitt, we're being seen around the world, including in Libya right now, and I assume some of those top military officers are watching CNN right now. If you have a chance to say something to these military brass in Libya right now, what would you say to them?
What I'd simply say is your leader has lost legitimacy. Your leader is asking you to kill your fellow citizens. That is an illegitimate order. If you continue to follow those orders, you yourself could either be indicted in a war crimes tribunal or could be taken out as a legitimate target in this campaign. You have a choice. You can either continue with Gaddafi or you can get on the right side of history and move forward to be a part of transitioning to a new Libya. It's your choice, and you need to make it quite soon.
How risky is this military operation for the men and women of the United States military?
Well, first and foremost, it's a tremendous risk to all those coalition pilots that are in the air right now. We cannot be assured of air supremacy at this point. I suspect these operations that we've been running for the last few hours have been able to take out much of the air defense and electronic jamming capabilities of the Libyans, probably not all. So we've got coalition airmen that are risking their lives right now for the people of Libya, putting their lives on the line.